Vice President Kamala Harris to Zi who were Doug Amhoff to shy the Halu Nyat on the Hmong Wausau Festival. Lukong Cheng Nyat Olu Shali Dinengo Shia Tienengo Yi. To Xiong No Yo Sang Wisconsin Governor Tony Evers, Dato Senator Tammy Baldwin, Ti Lieutenant Governor Sierra Rodriguez. Hosa Sujo No Yun De Minji, Ye Bei Shadam Shai Tao.
ต้องมาค่ะเทียตุกิโลนายันตัวยีเฮอเสือเจนเตอร์เปมองยัตโตชาเซนทรัลวิสคอนซินรองเชียร์ต่อสายเกาหลีวะจีกระโจงกัฟเวอร์เนอร์เซนเตอร์ลูสเตอร์กัฟเวอร์เนอร์เทียนดอโดจอนหน่อยจอจื้ออมม่วงมังหมอในต่อชีในรูชื่อเหอมวนุงกีตัวคีเปมองวอซอลูเฟสติวัลหุ่นนอเอทอว่าจื้อเยโชกอนได้ในทรัพย์ตัว
My name is Zomar Ka. I am here with Joy Yi Her, who represents the Hmong community of Central Wisconsin. We are pleased to welcome Second Gentleman, Governor, U.S. Senator, Lieutenant Governor, and all the distinguished guests here today. We are wishing that the heavens and God above would only grant all of us victory and good prosperity moving in the future. Woo-hoo!
Great to be here in Wisconsin. It's great to be here at the Hmong Festival. This is such an honor to be here. I bring greetings from Vice President Harris, and she says hi to everyone. And
yes!
Soon to be President Harris. And it's just an honor to be here and to celebrate with you. So I raise a glass. Cheers. Oh.
Once again, for the fifth time I've been here, this is a wonderful, wonderful event celebrating the Hmong history, culture, and the economic development that they provide the state of Wisconsin. So let's celebrate for them.
Thank you. I am delighted to join you. This is my first time to be at the Wausau Hmong Festival. I am so honored to be here, but it's not my first time visiting with the Hmong community here in the Wausau area and elsewhere around the state. You bring so much culture, tradition, and make Wisconsin a better state for being here.
This is Lieutenant Governor Sarah Rodriguez, and I am so excited to be here. This is my second time, and it just keeps getting bigger every time I come here, and more exciting. So I couldn't be happier to be here, and I think this is going to be a wonderful festival. So thank you for having me.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, let's welcome onto the stage the second gentleman of the United States, Doug Amhoff.
Wow. Thank you, Isaac. Thank you so much. Well, hello, Wisconsin. I think my wife was just here a few days ago. So it is really great to be here, and thank you, Yi, for organizing this incredible, amazing event, and thank you for having me at the Hmong Wausau Festival, my first time. You've heard from my very good friends, Governor Evers, who I get to see him behind the scenes. He's even better than this, behind the scenes, doing the work for all of you here in Wisconsin. And our good friend, Senator Baldwin, thank you. I think I met you when my wife was running for Senate, and you endorsed her when she was Attorney General, and you were supporting her then, and we came out here in 2018 to support both of you when you were running, and we've gotten to know each other really, really well, and we need to send her back to the United States Senate. And I also want to recognize and thank the Hmong Lao veterans we have here today. Please rise again. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for your service and for your commitment to protecting freedom. We really appreciate it. Well, how did I get here? Well, my great-great-grandparents came here from Poland, fleeing persecution. And now I stand here 125 years later as the first second gentleman of the United States. So, and we know that is not just my story. That is the story of so many families here today and so many families across our great nation. And it's also the story of my wife, Kamala Harris. She is the children of immigrants. And I've heard her talk so many times about her mother, who came to the United States from India alone. Yeah, wow. As a 19-year-old, she was a student. And her mother, and I never got to meet her, but I feel like I know her through everything that Kamala has told me about her. And she had two missions in life. One, to cure cancer, and two, to raise her daughters, Kamala and Maya. And one of those daughters, just with that background, is now the Vice President of the United States and maybe the next President of the United States. It's an amazing country. That is our country. That is America. And that's who we are. Now, as second gentleman, I've seen firsthand the way the Asian American and Native Hawaiian Pacific Islander communities are moving this country forward. I've heard from community leaders all across the country about their work towards so many of the goals that we all share: investing in economic development, tackling the climate crisis, empowering women, and much, much more. Now, it's being second gentleman turned out to be a pretty amazing gig. I've traveled to South Korea. I've traveled to the Philippines. I've traveled to Japan. I've traveled to Thailand. I've gotten to see the world. And I've been told I have to get back to Japan and Thailand for the Hmong New Year's Festival, I heard. Okay. So here at home, I've also been focused on fighting hate. Hate of all kinds, including hate against Asian Americans, Native Hawaiians, and Pacific Islanders. And as some of you may have heard and may have seen when she was here, Kamala and I have had a very busy week. It's not even been a week, but on Sunday, We all witnessed a stunning act of patriotism by our great President Joe Biden. As always, throughout his entire career, Joe Biden put his country first. And make no mistake, President Biden is going to go down as one of the most consequential presidents in our history. I am still in awe of his courage and commitment to our democracy. But the funny thing is, you all probably heard about his announcement before I did. I didn't have my phone on me when it happened. I was with some friends grabbing coffee in Los Angeles. I had gone there to see my parents and my son and his wife. And a friend of mine showed me his phone with the announcement, and I said, I gotta go. So I ran to the car. I think my agents were trying to figure out what was going on and followed me, and there was my phone in the car, and I think there were, 20 messages. Call Kamala, call Kamala, call Kamala. And she said, where were you? I need you. And I said, she said, all right, well, look, president called me, you saw the news, let's get to work. Let's get to work and earn this nomination, and we need to unite our party, unite our country, and move us forward. And that was our conversation last Sunday. It's now Saturday, and that's what we've been doing for this past week, and that is why I'm right here in Wisconsin today. Thank you. And I think there's a reason why the party coalesced around her in just a day or two. I think there's a reason that over 100,000 new volunteers have signed up to help her campaign. It's because we've seen a leader emerge. We've seen somebody emerge that people have faith in, that people believe in. They've seen her leadership as vice president. They've watched her and Joe Biden lift this country out of the depths of COVID and economic despair and made the United States the envy of the world, which it always rightfully is. A lot has changed since Biden-Harris administration took over in early 2021. I remember being here in Wisconsin in those early days. Businesses were still recovering. We were just trying to come out of COVID. In fact, Dr. Biden and I visited one of the vaccination clinics here. And now look where we are now. Over 15 million new jobs. Wages are rising faster than inflation. Small businesses have more access to capital. And that's because of Joe Biden and Kamala Harris's leadership. And now we need to move forward. We need to move forward. We need to build on that progress. And in that spirit, I want to take a moment to talk about my wife, Kamala Harris, and her vision for the future. It's a future where everyone has a place. It's an America for everyone, not just for some of us. It's a future that fulfills our nation's promise to protect our rights and freedoms, not take them away. It's a future that builds up the middle class and small businesses instead of tax cuts to billionaires and the biggest corporations. It's a future that protects our environment instead of catering to big oil. It's a future with fewer guns on our streets and more books in our schools. It's a future where everyone can have access to affordable health care and retire with dignity that they deserve. It's a future where we're not divided by hate. It's a future where we're united by a shared vision of our country, a shared vision of equality and opportunity for all of us, not just some of us. So this is just some of the vision for America's future of my wife, Kamala Harris. And it's a vision that's born of her values as a person. So let me tell you a little bit about that person. The Kamala Harris that I know and love, and I get to see a little bit behind the scenes each and every day. You may know or not, we met on a blind date. About 11 or 12 years ago, I was a lawyer. I had a client in the office, and the client said something like, "Are you single?" at the end of a one-hour meeting. And she said, "I think you and my best friend will probably get along with each other." She saw that you're both lawyers. She could tell we both cared about our communities. We were both fighters. We both stick up for people. And a week later, I went on a blind date with the Attorney General of California. And I will say it was love at first sight. We connected. We had a passion for the law, but we also had a hatred of bullies. We had a hatred of people who picked on other people. And both of us, we learned right on that first date, is that we spent a lifetime, but also made it a career as lawyers, of sticking up for other people. And we, even on our first date, by the end of that night, we were talking about our future. And maybe not this part, but we were talking about our future as a couple and how this might work. And what we both, you know, knew was that we wanted to be together and do it together. And over the last decade, she's not just been an amazing partner to me, but a loving parent to two kids named Cole and Ella. From day one, she's been present, nurturing, and fiercely protective of them. My daughter, Ella, just posted on Instagram, "I love my three parents." And I could not say it better. Whether it was officiating recently at our son Cole's wedding, or flying cross-country through the night to make it to Ella's graduation, Kamala's always been there for them. So trust me, there's no one you want fighting more for your kids than Kamala Harris. The Kamala I know is strong and passionate. She stands up for what she believes in, and she never backs down from a fight. But she understands that public service isn't self-service. It's not about her or her opponent, really. And it's no matter what kind of weird stuff they keep saying. Public service is about you. It's about us. It's about delivering results for the American people and standing up for our rule of law and our democracy and our freedoms. That's what it's about. And good news, folks, we have an election in about 100 days. So the best way that we can preserve our freedom, move our country forward, continue this progress, is at the ballot box. So that's why it's so important for everyone here and in this community to register to vote. Doesn't mean it matter who you vote for. That's what they fought for. That's what this country is all about. To preserve our democracy, you need to participate in it. So first, go out and register to vote. Get your friends, get your family, get everyone you know to register to vote, one. And then you gotta make your voices heard. So if you believe in, like I said, a country that values everyone, that values freedom, our rights, and moving forward, then take a look at voting for my wife, Kamala Harris. I know we would appreciate that. But by the way, these elections are all close. We know we're gonna have to earn this. We know they're always gonna be close. And we know they're always close right here in Wisconsin, right, Senator, right, Governor? And we also know that this community right here could decide the election in this state, which could decide the election, the entire election. So you have the power right here in this Hmong community. You have more power than you realize. Your coming together as a community could really dictate the results of this election. We're 100 and plus days, about 100 from election day, 100 days from deciding the future of our country. So get out there and register and vote for the future that you want and the future in which we all belong. Thank you so much for having me. It's such an honor to be here.
TV, Doug Amhoff.
Why is it so important for you to start your campaign run here in Wausau, Wisconsin, and more importantly, you know, having a special guest appearance here at the festival.
Yeah, we wanted to be at the Hmong Wausau Festival. This is something that we wanted to come to. This is a big deal here, and we take this area, the state, very seriously, and we're going to earn every vote, including in the Hmong community. And it's also a celebration of who we are as Americans. As you know, Kamala Harris is the daughter of two immigrants, and so she really understands that experience. And so she represents the future. And Kamala Harris, in her presidency, there'll be a world where everyone has a place, and including right here. So it's just an honor to be here. I can't wait to get out there and participate in the ceremonies.
So what do you know about the Hmong community?
Well, I spent a lot of time in Wisconsin and Minnesota, so I've gotten to know the community a little bit, and certainly traveling around the country, I have met people of all different, from all different places, including the Hmong community. And of course, coming here, I wanted to make sure I was ready, so we did some research on this event and this community, and when they came and how this community has flourished and developed over the last 40 or 50 years or so. It's just very impressive.
Become active. Why the big thing John and move the short term vote for in November no more.
Kutu ya kuli moishi ka ya tsashia ya tsapa wa kumwa blanchia blanc kutia jang kutia hai tia kulu ka ka ilan o kume blanchia ka pa pa tia kulu ka Oh, tu me blanchia, yon dong tia cu lu co cha.
Vice President Kamala Harris, Lord President Washington DC, Festival. Social media Tu chen su nyo medahan Colombia don dai to tu neng pe tu tun zo when you quad kedi chin dai to la no tu neng no ya tu na lu cho t-shirt da li pon da dai do no e hai tia nu wa chao to ja tu chen su to le zo ke don dai tu neng pe jo no Taukena Minnesota Governor Tim Walz won Friday Shaliti Nango Jo Achenango Blau Ju Minnesota Olympias Day Lower Gajong Shia Doko Otu Gila Watomukong John Dete Jokila Gang Chaplo Nyato 2024 Paris Summer Olympics Governor Walz Haitia Nukwa Tejong Shihang Do Jokila No Walo Shou Jay Lusang Minnesota Mujo Paris Nihanzitia, Zhongliya Law, Sang Minnesota, Ying Mu, Daoya, Law Wagay Jong Shia, Nyato Lujai Mu, Olympic Lino. Tashino, Samong Biles, Tia Sunisa Lee, Qualify Mujo Team Finals. Nyato Nu Tuesday, Yola No. Niyang Wato Jong Kangao La, Beijong Shia Tia Kwa, Beimong Tun Tai Sunisa Lee. The Naya Beimong TV Newsbrief, Guya Yao Mua.